Hello, today we're going to do a really quick tutorial on Go Imagine, and this is specifically to add variations to your products. So editing a product on Go Imagine or adding a product is best done on your computer. It can be done on a cell phone. It's just not as user-friendly. It takes a little bit longer, and you could run into some little glitches. So I recommend doing it on your computer. So here I have this listing, and I've already filled out everything, but just a quick overview. Name is the same as the title of the listing on Go Imagine. Generally, they recommend for those to be a little bit shorter than they would on Etsy, for example, where some people really like to fill in every single possible character. That's not as important on Go Imagine. As of right now, keep in mind things can always change. Then there's categories. You get to choose two categories, and you have to choose from the options here, and you can search for categories, or you can select and you can narrow down and get deeper and deeper into subcategories, but you can only choose two for that. So if you just start typing something, then it'll give you options. For example, if I was looking for Halloween, it's under holiday and seasonal Halloween. So I don't want that, but oops. Okay. And then you have your custom shop categories, which you get to create. And we can do a separate video on that if people are interested. Then you have your price. Then you have your description. Pretty straightforward. You can add a lot of different things to your description, including links and different things like that. You can change colors, you can make them bold, all sorts of fun stuff. Then you have your status, active, disabled, or hidden, so you can keep it disabled until you're ready to list it, for example. Then you have your images, and I don't know if there's any limit to the number of images. There's definitely not a really small limit because I feel like you just keep adding. As soon as you add another one, then another box opens, and so on and so forth. So you can add a lot of images in there. You can put a SKU number if you would like. That's just completely optional for you. If you don't really understand what that means, then you probably aren't at the point necessarily that you need to have SKU number. List price. Now there was the price above, and then there's the list price. This allows you to kind of list things on sale. So if I have the list price at $14.99 and up above I had a price of $9.99, it shows regular price at $14.99 and then a little cross through it and then $9.99. So it looks like it's on sale basically. Your inventory quantity on stock, and then this inventory button, you have two options here: track inventory, unlimited, do not track. I honestly am not 100% sure. I just keep a close eye and make sure I disable listings if I don't have any left, and just try to keep a close eye on that personally. Then you have your search keywords, which if you hover over this question mark, which by the way, there's a few of these on here, then it gives you that information. Search keywords are used to find products in Go Imagine Search. Remember to put singular and plural words. Separate words with commas or underscore. So, Go Imagine is a little bit different than Etsy. You just fill it all into this box here, and you do need to put plurals where you don't with Etsy, for example, and that will help people find your items. And there is a character count limit at some point, but it's pretty. There's quite a bit that you can fit in there. And then there's a shipping time frame or promo text. You can kind of put anything you want right here. You can put that you're having a sale. You can put really just like literally whatever you want in there. Just keep it short is kind of their recommendation. So from there's a bunch of other tabs up here. So you go back up to the top and you've got how it's made. That's where you can describe how the item's made. And I believe you have an option to put a picture to help show that. You describe the materials, whatever you want to put there. It's really up to you. And then there's room for images down below. Then there's SEO. This is important. You do want to fill this out. You're basically copying information from the general tab over. So you've got it shows you the name. Basically, it's the link that your listing will be under, page title, description, and keywords. Description, usually you want to keep shorter here. You don't want to fill in an entire description of 200 characters with all sorts of extra information. You just want to have a short description. But then once again, keywords here, you want to pretty much copy the same keywords if you can. So, and then this gives you an idea down below of what this would look like if somebody Googled personal painted wood magnet and wood pumpkin magnet and my item showed up. It would show a picture, and then this is kind of the basic information that someone would see right off the bat. And then we get to options, and this is where you can put your variations. So you can add an option, and once you add the option, then you're actually able to reuse it over and over again. So you can link an existing option. So I have all these options that I've saved in here, and so color option, color choices is a common one here, or I have this one called any color. So you can kind of name them whatever you want, and that is for your information as well, so you can keep track of it. So you don't have to do this on every single listing. You do this once and then you're good to go. So let's say we wanted to add an option here and we wanted to call it multiples discount. And this is a way that you can do a discount when people buy more than one. And then you can just put the code as the same. I don't remember what the code was for. And then position is if there's more than one option that you want to give people. Let's say you want to give them an option for the main color of the item, but you also want to give them an option for a quantity discount. Then first, I want them to choose how many they want. And so I would make this number one. And then if I wanted the second option to show up being the color, then that would be in position number two. That's kind of complicated. But once you try it out, you'll see. You get to decide here if you want them to choose from a drop-down box, a checkbox. There can be a text area where they just type in what they want. So you have multiple options there. And then description. And so this is where you tell them what to do. So you say, please type here what color you would like. Or for a quantity discount, buy more and save. Just leave it as simple as that. And then comment is just a shortened version of the description. And then if you check this box for required, they have to answer this question. Or if you leave it open, then it's optional. And then this Google thing isn't really super important either, I don't think. If it falls into one of these categories, you may want to choose one of those categories, but otherwise it wouldn't matter. So then if you were happy with this, then you have to go on to variance. And the variance would be, in the quantity example, you would say for the first option, quantity, I can't spell quantity, one, and then you can hit the plus sign here, and then you would do second option would be quantity two, quantity three, and then I could put here better deal, and then I could put best deal, for example. And there's another way to do quantity discounts in here. It's just something that came into my mind. So basically, the modifier type can be a dollar amount or a percent amount. I think most commonly it'd be a dollar amount. So basically we're saying quantity one, you're not going to be paying anything extra for one. But then if you're quantity two, let's say you'll only be paying $5 extra for getting two. And then so on. And if you don't want to charge extra for your different options, like it's just colors, for example, don't even do anything there. You can, I think it's under extra, I guess. Yeah. Then you can upload an image. So that way, if you have different colors, this is where you associate a certain photo to the color options that you're giving or the size options that you're giving or whatever it can be. You can create the photo for that. And then you would just hit create, and then your option would be saved, or let you know if you forgot anything. And then once you have one saved, for example, on this one, you can choose for it to be an ornament or a magnet. So this is what it looks like. And I chose radio group. I don't remember what that means exactly. I think it just means a list of choices. Basically, they have to click on one. And then on my comment, I just put, would you like your item to be an ornament or a magnet? And I put that in both spots there. For variance, I chose one ornament, one magnet. And then no price difference. They can get either for the same price. And then I had another one that I had for color. And then this one, I did text area. Choose any color. Type what you want here. You can also send me a picture. Describe the color that you would like. The photos are just some examples. Anything is possible, etc., etc. And then on the comments, I think I did a really long version. I would have preferred to do a shorter one. And then I made this required. So they have to put that in or they can't complete the order until they answer the question, what color they want. So that one was pretty simple. And then I have a third one on here that says magnet or ornament. So that one's pretty weird. I need to take a look at that actually. That does not look right. So if we go to preview and look at what this listing looks like with these variants on here. So once again, here's how it looks with the sale. List price $14.99. Its price is $9.99. You save $5. They put a nice bold thing here for free shipping. And then, yeah, I have an issue here because I have ornament or magnet, and that all makes sense. And then they can hover over this question mark, and it asks, you know, gives them that little information, color, type the color that you want here. And then I have magnet or ornament below. And clearly this is broken. It just has one checkbox. That's clearly wrong. So I actually need to go in here and I need to remove this one. So we want to disable it because if I delete that, then I'm just deleting that and it could affect another listing and I'm not sure. So we're just going to disable it so it's not part of this one. I think that's right. It might be that I needed to delete it here. I'm not 100% sure. You have to play around with it. So don't make a really complicated variant in here and then accidentally delete it completely. Make some really simple ones and try it out first. And then from there, you can go back in and do play with it more once you figure it out, because I just don't want to tell anybody the wrong thing. And then I've got free shipping. I don't know a whole lot about how to do it when you're charging for shipping, because I'm just doing free shipping to make it easier for myself, and I just calculate that in. Then there's optional settings where you can have a YouTube URL. Then there is this quantity discounts. So this is another way to do quantity discounts instead of doing it the way that I was just using it as an example. Files to sell is just if you are doing printables or digital files, and that's where you would add the files. So when they go and buy it and the money goes through, then they automatically get that file. And then Google Feed is important if you want to be found on Google for your items. And it's just a couple of quick things. You don't have to fill out gender unless it's clothing or something that really affects the gender or size type. I just put adult in here, which is not necessarily important either. It's magnet, whatever. But you need to pick a good category for this Google product category. So don't forget to do that. So those are the most important things there. And it's always, of course, important to save. And one little tidbit that I will give you about saving your listings and all that is save multiple times, because these can get kind of complicated. Once you get a couple of photos on here, that's when I hit save. And then I go in and add a few more photos, because every once in a while, a photo won't load and you can hit delete and remove, but it still thinks it's trying to load a photo and then it won't save. And so if you've done a whole bunch of work, that work won't be saved. And then another thing to keep in mind is the clone option. So that is so you can copy everything about this listing onto another one and then go in and just make those little changes. So if you have a lot of similar items, it's going to save you tons and tons of time. Don't make a new listing for every single item you have. Pretty much everybody who sells something, they sell some similar items generally. So you really want to use the clone button. So that is all I have for today. Please definitely take a look at subscribing to my channel to get more helpful advice and information for Etsy and GoImagine sellers. And also please remember to hit the like button if you found this video interesting, entertaining, or helpful in any way.